Good morning, guys. Here we go with the Kiss America's AM race. We're doing three laps of the new Volcano Flat Circuit. Let's jump in and find out how we're getting on. Let's just get up to the front. We're not taking part in this race today. We're choked with a cold, hence the voice. Sorry for that. So, we couldn't miss the chance to see the new volcano route though. So, we'll just jump ahead, try and find the front of the pack. As usual with the Kiss race, we're talking full out effort for the first few hundred metres. And then it'll settle down a little. Callejo from the KR team pushing out 6.2 watts per kilo as we come up that little rise. Here we go at the front now. Lan Van Boom, one of the Kiss guys. We've got Neil Duffy from the BRT race team. So the Volcano Flat route, we're looking at doing three laps of Watopia Forward Flat with the addition of the new Volcano circuit. So we're looking at about 37 kilometres for the race. It's going to be a fast one. Coming in down through the tunnel just now. Guys are pushing out a good effort just now. 140 beats per minute for Callejo. 2.9 watts per kilo. For anyone that wonders what we're watching just now, we're watching virtual game Zwift. All these riders that you see are real riders around the world, attached to a trainer. Bike trainer in their house, connected to their computer via Ant Plus technology or Bluetooth, as they might be using the iOS software, and they're pushing out real watts. They're turning the pedals, and those watts are getting turned into the digital space inside the computer, which is then pushing their avatar along. The more watts you push in real life, the faster the avatar goes. So you see here just now, Callejo, that we're watching, 3 watts per kilo, 240 watts. That's what he's physically putting out down through his pedals in his room over in Spain. And he's keeping up with the front group just now. Let's chuck him a little ride on, shall we? Any one of these riders that's using a smart trainer right now, this 3.3% gradient is going to kick in and they're going to actually feel like they are going uphill. They've got to put out more effort to keep that pace going. here we can see the steam rising from the volcano just behind, just up front there. This, I believe, is the first official race that's using the volcano route, so very exciting. For those that aren't on Swift or are new to Swift, we've been riding around Watopia for, 2 years now, so it's really exciting that we've got a new route to try. It's all about the environment within Swift, so when you get a new road to try out, although you're still just on your trainer, pushing out your watts, doing your work, if you've got some new environment to look at, then that's a big thing. So I think this is going to be a very popular expansion. Nicely packed group, what we're looking at, maybe 20, 30 riders. Neil Duffy just at the back of this pack here. Strong rider from the BRT team. 164 beats per minute just now. So this guy's putting out some effort, hanging in with this group. 4 watts per kilo. Trying to check across at swiftpower.com. We don't seem to have any live information just now. Coming down into the Italian village. And then I believe from here, this is where we're going to take the turn into the volcano. Yep, here we go, turning off. See that new fountain. Fantastic piece of graphics work here from the Swift team. Down through the dust. Heading down, little switchbacks to the back of the Italian village here. And then into the new volcano area. There it is. The lava pouring down. And it looks like from a ride we did yesterday, round the outside of the volcano there's going to be a new track. So a new climb. It's not open just now. It's got some construction work sitting outside it. The troops obviously haven't moved in yet to get that building out of the way. So obviously there'll be a lot of speculation as to when that route's going to go live. Ian Anderson here from the KRT team, teammate of mine, riding in the B category, hanging at the front of the group, pushing out 3.7 watts per kilo, 157 beats, working hard. We're back. I think we lost the stream there for a second, but it looks like we're back online. Again, apologies for the voice. Struggling with a bit of a cold today, so.
And we're back. I think we lost the stream there for a second, but it looks like we're back online.
Again, apologies for the voice. Struggling with a bit of a cold today, so
we're back. I think we lost the stream there for a second, but at least we're back online.
Again, apologies for the voice. Struggling with a bit of a cold today, so
we're back. I think we lost the stream there.
4.75 watts per kilo from Ian as he crests this little rise, 4.4%. Just a little kick up and over the top. Keeping the speed high. 4.75 watts per kilo from Ian as he crests this little rise. 4.4%. Just a little kick up and over the top. Keeping the speed high. 4.75 watts per kilo from Ian as he crests this little rise. 4.4%. Just a little kick up and over the top, keeping the speed high. 4.75 watts per kilo for me as he press this little rise. 4.4%. Just a little. coming up to complete their first lap just now. Neil Duffy, 7.7 watts per kilo there, trying to push on 500 watts, laying down some serious power here, trying to make a break. 53 kilometres an hour, there we go, past the finish line for the first lap. Two more laps to go. ...124 races Neil Duffy has completed so far within Zwift. Took the win last week in this very race, Kiss America's race. I bet he's hoping to do the same again today. Let's see what happens. Four seconds back from the lead. We've got Hellboy up front. Hellboy still keeping a lead out at the front. 4 seconds gap just now. Okay, and we've got Zwift powered up now. We've got some results coming through from the live. Now it looks like Hellboy's been a bit of a naughty boy, and he's down for a DQ just now. Not sure what that's about. Possibly it's his higher than average power. We're looking at a 8.3 watts per kilo 2 minute power. Not quite sure that's right. Okay, so he's dropped back a little bit. This lead group now featuring Neil Duffy. from the BRT team. Zed smoking. J Mitsutuanami. And D Madsen. Mizutani from Japan. One of the lead riders here just now. Just checking out some of his race results. Strong, solid rider. A category, got a couple of silvers in there. Best performance, 4.7 watts per kilo. Twenty-minute power of 277 watts. So a strong, strong rider here. On. This is the second lap out of the three that they're doing. 175 beats per minute, working hard. Anyone that thinks these guys are not working hard, they really haven't tried out Zwift yet. This is real racing. It might be virtual world, but this is real racing. These guys are in their homes, maybe even at work. They're pushing out real power through their pedals. That's connecting into the computer. And yep, this is a game, but this is a real live effort that people are putting down just now. ...175 beats per minute, working really hard, 5.4 watts per kilo, pushing 43 kilometers. The speed certainly in Zwift, it's a lot faster than in real life, but then you've got to think, there's no wind, there's no rolling resistance, it's just pure power. Watching Zed smoking here. 4.5 watts per kilo, 4.6, 300 watts coming down into the cutoff at the Italian village. Second lap. Lead group here of what, four riders. There's that volcano. Fantastic piece of graphics work from the Zwift guys. We've been waiting a couple of months for this since we were first told by Ekman, the CEO. And I have to say, it looks good. Definitely looks good. It's going to add a new element to the racing. So Zed smoking. Malaysia, I think that is. That is flag. Malaysia. Looks like this is his first race. There's no details on him on Swift Power. D Madsen here in with the lead group. I think he might be heading towards an upgrade. He's entered into the B category, but he's clearly pushing Watts for an A rider. That might just be a little typo that he's made there. But he's certainly throwing down some serious power here to keep with this main group. Into the volcano again. Little kicker here just to keep the legs going. See the construction there on the left? That's for the new route, which is obviously going to go up and round the outside of the volcano. So it'll be interesting to see when that gets launched, because that looks like a good hefty climb. Inside. Short little circuit inside. And I'll be kind of heading back out. Out the other side, into this new tunnel, which whips us back round to just past the S's, yep, before heading down into the finish line to complete the second lap. That lava flowing into the water, eh? Fantastic. the long drag down here to the finish. Looks like Neil's trying to push it on. 4.5 watts per kilo, 180 beats per minute, working super hard. 50k coming down to the finish line to complete the second lap. Again, apologies about the voice, choked with the cold. Would have been good to be in the race today, checking out this new route. Nice little circuit. So one lap to go. We've got a lead group of four. Sorry, we've got a lead group of three. So we've got Neil Duffy from the BRT team coming out of Britain. Mitsutani from Japan and Smokin from Malaysia. So they head down Ocean Boulevard for one last time. Expect to see them pushing hard here down this incline, this decline, get some speed up. 8.1 watts from Neil there. Smoking's made a little gap for himself. Using the aero power up there. But as we know, power ups are for. Yeah, okay. We'll leave that one, shall we? So Zed Smoking here, 4 second gap. Back to D Madsen. H Ichikawa, N Duffy, and J Mitsutani. They're pulling them back 2 seconds now. And now we're all back together. The Zwift guys really have done a great job with their product. Just like racing in the real world, if you're out front on your own, you need to be pushing down some serious effort if you want to stay away from the group. The group's got the draft, they can work together. So unless you're a really strong rider, the best place to be is in the small group at the front. And then maybe, if you've got a kick, you can go for the sprint at the end. So ahead of the race here, we've got a three-man attack for the lead. Who do you think's going to take it? Do you think the cold helps my Scottish tones, Johnny? To be fair, I think I would rather race. Do you think the cold helps my Scottish tones, Johnny? Let's see, do we think Neil's going for the win? 4.5, 4.9. Strong rider,
fair,
Neil.
I think I would rather race. Do you think the cold helps my Scottish tones, Johnny?
Let's see, do we think Neil's going for the win? 4.5, 4.9. Strong rider,
fair,
Neil.
I think I would rather race. Do you think the cold helps my Scottish tones, Johnny?
Do we think Neil's going for the win? 4.5, 4.9. Strong rider, Neil.
I think I would rather race. Do you think the cold helps my Scottish tones, Johnny?
Let's see, do we think Neil's going for the win? 4.5, 4.9. Strong rider, Neil.
I think I would rather race.
Apologies there for the technical difficulties, folks. As I said at the beginning, first live stream here today. Not quite got all the technicalities down yet, but we've closed that browser, so no more repeat. Just in time to see the guys coming through the Italian village one last time. Short sprint through the volcano, and then we'll be down, I think, for a full-on sprint for the finish. Between these three riders. So sticking with the lead guys here. Apologies for that if you want to see more of the race. We'll try and skip back later on, but being the first post, first stream, I don't want to miss the end. So we're just gonna stick with these guys. Looking over onto Swift Power, it looks like the bees are being led. By R. Zund, followed by P. Lavery of Team X. Ian Anderson from the KRT in there in the mix as well. Smoking, looking like he's trying to make a little break up that little incline. Duffy's got the wheel though. Okay, here we are, we're coming up to the sharp end of the race. Two guys in it, Zed Smoking and N Duffy. Who are you going to place your bets on? Being biased and a fellow Scot, I'm going to have to go with Neil. But you never know what's going to happen in the end. Left turn here, and then we're into the home straight. Okay, so Neil's opened up a 1 second gap. 1 second on this last sprint. It can be easily overtaken. Let's see him opening it up. 6.6, 6.3. He should be pushing at least 7 on his sprint. I've seen him do that before. Smoking up to 12 watts per kilo. And he's got it. So Smoking takes the win. Duffy in second place. Good good race there from the guys. 37k in 48 minutes. That's a good effort. Good effort. Hard work. Let's see if we can jump back and find the bees. Just missed the bees coming through the line there. Stand about, come on, put some effort in those pedals. No, seriously guys, so thanks very much for watching. As I say, apologies for the voice, cold's hitting me today, so that's why we're sitting trying this instead of doing the racing. It was good fun. I hope you enjoyed listening to it. I know there was a couple of little technical difficulties there, but I'm sure we'll get them ironed out. There's a lot of good experience in the community, so we'll be tapping into some of that later on. And so thanks for tuning in, and I'll catch you another time soon. Cheers, folks.